Hey everybody, it's Slink. It's Slink on the TV!
And Ato here.
And Arc Ray is taking control again. Keeping that control. Okay, fine, keep it. It's your turn anyway.
It's my turn on the controller now. So, one thing we were talking a bit during the commercial break, as it were, was like the oddity of how Luda here, yes, that is her name. Wait, I'm pretty sure.
Yes, it is. Even I can remember it now. I got it right earlier when I said it wrong the first time, but I said it right later.
Right. The thing that struck me odd is that like she seems really tall when Link is just like right up by her, and yet she apparently seems so young, like compared to Colin and the others. And then it got me thinking that she's probably having a similar thing going on for her that the character Ayane from Persona 4 had going on. Now that was a character who is like an optional social link for the Sun, to where one of her character quirks was that even though she was going to the same school as the main character, everyone always treated her way younger than what she actually was. In fact, if I remember correctly, during the school festival, she was complaining how even though, like, well, for me, like, I took her there as a date,
yeah,
that all of the stand people that were working the booths kept treating her like your little sister. I thought, that's amusing. So, I actually, like, came across a little bit of information, and that would explain why it is that she seems the way she does, and that is that she is actually apparently rather close in age to Link. Like, according to my source here, which I'm sure Ray will probably throw up for you, she's 15.
Okay. And how old is Link? 17?
Pretty sure he's 17.
I'm just kind of throwing it out there because I'm always assuming that's the age of adult Link.
Like, I feel like that was the age that was given for Ocarina of Time when Link becomes an adult, and ever since then that's just kind of become like the default. Oh yeah, whenever Link is an adult he's like 17 or something.
Well, the only number I remember being given is 7 years later, so I was like, wait, if he's adult Link, what does that consider? Does that mean he's 20? Does that mean he was 13 or 10? It's like I didn't know what that meant back in the day when I tried to think about that.
Ah.
You know, like reading the strategy guide that was inside of a Game Informer? Game Pro. Game Pro back in the day, an old Game Pro we had. And it had like a mini guide for Ocarina of Time.
Yeah, but I never would have figured that she was actually really close in age to Link.
But I'll throw up that little sketch source. Just let me... Oh, there it is. Except to throw it up. I threw it up. There it is on the screen. Everybody's going to see it.
Okay. Anyways, back on with the game.
Yeah, I'm getting dizzy now. That poor Zora boy, he must have been through something awful. Didn't we do this? I hope you start feeling better soon. Oh, I didn't read that. I cut it off because my turn was over. And the Zora boy both went out. Ilya goes to the sanctuary every day. I think she prays there. Zora boy prays too. Every day he goes to the graveyard and stays for hours. How can I make them be happy again? Oh, bother, what is a young little child to do,
well,
being the hero of Kakariko Village?
Obviously, it is must be a situation of social link go.
No, no. That text is going up anyway, but no.
Do you not remember that picture?
Actually, no, I don't. I have no idea what you're referencing.
I'll give that to you, too, to throw.
Stop referencing that! This better be all bundled in a good email with timestamps that I won't know anything about. Because I'll do it myself as time goes on.
Okay,
I do it all the time. I edit my videos probably not the right way. But again, I never asked anybody who else is on YouTube. I probably should have done that when I talked to YouTubers at this friggin', what's it called?
Convention?
Screw Attack Gaming Convention. I was trying to remember the name. Thanks for helping with that. It was very great how you didn't do that at all. Greetings, Link. HD. I felt Ilya could use a change of scenery to improve her health, so we came here. Who knows, if she gets out and sees daily life, perhaps something will jog her memory. Maybe like you. Perhaps you could go keep her in your thoughts? No? Okay. Well, that's alright then. Link HD. If anything happens, I will let you know, but till then, please keep her in your thoughts. How are you gonna let him know instantly? Is the postman that fast? Oh, Link. HD. You have gone through so much trouble for me. I'm so sorry. Colin and the others have told me so much about you, Link. They tell me that you're brave and kind and that you heard very well. Herding. I feel like I know what that means. That means you must be a good rider, huh? Oh, and the name of your horse is Epona HD, right? Epona HD? What a lovely name. So high quality, too. I'm very good at sensing a horse's feelings, and I can tell that Epona trusts you with all of her HD goodness that she has. You would never ask her to do too much, right? Are we sure she has lost her memory? She's acting a little too much like herself. For a second, that rug looked like it wasn't really textured properly, like it was crayon or something.
Yeah.
But it's just awkward looking.
Well, you know, even if the memory is gone, the soul still burns.
Just like the history with all them swords and stuff, eternally retold.
Yeah, that retelling got pretty old around the fifth time.
Yeah, because they weren't retelling it anymore. That was a new story.
Yeah, at that point, they were just slurring it. Like, I swear they forgot, like, a few characters as they were retelling it.
Hold on, I got a good one. The Tale of Souls and Swords, Eternally Retold. Hold on, there's a bit of a smudge here. Hold on, we can probably get that out. Oh, crap, we can't. Oh, no, now I guess we'll just have to leave it in there. And thus we have a new story that nobody ended up really liking too much.
Yeah, this character reminds me a lot of another character.
Bug.
Oh, wait a minute.
I feel like we have this bug already.
Yep, there is a smudge on this character description here. Apparently she had red hair, not
white.
Platinum blonde white hair, whatever.
It was just white hair. Run, there's birds. There's nothing over here for you. I blew up all the rocks in the shortcut to the area.
But this is the way to, like, the Zora's grave, isn't it?
Oh, okay, it is.
Because...
would the Zorba be
Realis?
Here?
Realis?
I think it would be Realis.
Yeah, like they were saying.
Oh, he is here. Okay, never mind. I didn't remember. I guess it makes sense because if he wasn't in the graveyard, he had to be somewhere.
I was told that like he goes there and just like prays and.
Hello, is your name Link? Please don't make me say it every time.
Hey, you named him.
Yeah, so I didn't pronounce all the time when I'm. Are you named Link HD? My mother came to me in a dream. She showed me your image. She spoke of a youth who would save our domain and steer my fate, one named Link, of high definition. I must thank you for all you've done. If there's anything I can ever do for you, please tell me. Maybe even a drink from my odd-looking bottle satchel here. It's the elixir of life. I don't normally share it with people, though. Pretty much actually never, really, in the first place. But if you really, really want it...
Well, as you can see, I wear earrings, and that's a pretty sweet earring you have on.
Please.
Yeah.
In case there's anything you'd want from him.
But still, like, you know, get a better look at his design, since, like,
he's got a reddish color more than I remember. Like his mama, who was very red.
Right, and I never quite noticed that. What'd be the point of having, like, a 3-pronged water bottle?
I don't know.
And we see his warrior fins are starting to come in.
Actually, maybe. That's a very good thing. That's a very good point indeed. I wonder if they put different detailing on the eyes. Get out the Hawkeye lens. You're going to have to put it on a button. I moved it.
Okay.
Sorry. This is going to happen a lot between us playing differently. We have different button setups. Right stick. There you go. Boy, those are very cat-like eyes for a... It's a very cat-like face, actually. What the heck? That's all I expected.
Huh.
I could swear it wasn't like that before, but then again, I never did this before in the Wii version. Like, those are definitely cat's eyes for pupils, but then the nose looks like a cat nose from that angle. Like, it's only the bottom part of the nose, but because of how it is, it just looks like a cat nose.
Yeah, I made the joke about, like, the earring.
They are really pretty cool-looking. Let's steal him.
Right, but I was making a joke towards how, like, later on you need to get, like, this special lore which he wears as an... That is a prince, right? Did it say prince?
Yeah, his name is Prince Rallis.
Okay,
it's just... I swear, like, it was, you know, a necklace
from this
thing.
Like, boy, it looks like a girl.
Yeah, for that
but,
angle.
Like, I could have sworn he said, like, you know, he had an earring.
It was like a Zora's hook or something.
Yeah, it was like a red hook, but, like, I can't see his ears. I would assume that, like, they would be there.
Yeah, I would assume the fins of the ears, too.
I guess it's not so much HD to actually have it, like, on his character model at the time.
Yeah.
But still, like, you know, what is the benefit of having, like, you know, 3 prongs on your bottle.
It looks like it's just a bottle. I don't think it's anything else, really. I mean, it's got three corks. If it's a musical instrument, why would you do that in the first place? Why would you put corks on it?
Yeah, but I'm just kind of like, two, I can kind of understand. To allow for pressure so, like, that it can actually empty out better. But why three?
I guess the world may never know.
Unless it fills it up faster?
Didn't notice the quote-unquote toe detailing on the fin feet there. Because there's clearly lines going on that would be like the bones of a foot if this was to be considered human-like. Which, I mean, look at it. It's like a human. It's shaped like it, mostly.
Never noticed that anklet before. Alright. And, think that's a variant on the Zora's...
I actually first noticed that when you were zooming out after the first zoom in. I was just like, that looks cool. Link, I have so little confidence. What can I do? I could not even carry out one simple test for my mother. I'm so unlike her, I doubt I'm even qualified to rule. Okay.
Okay, well, that's enough of character building, or world building, as I like to refer to it, for now. Now it's time to literally build the world, because you just got done donating to that bridge, didn't you?
Mm-hmm.
And do we need to actually, like, let a day pass in order for something to actually come of that?
Didn't the day... No way, the day didn't pass since then.
Yeah.
Try going back to the town and talking to them, since you've done a zone out at this point, like, twice.
Huh. I guess that is technically true.
By the way, can you remember your buttons at all? You know, so you don't press all the wrong things again.
I'm getting better, like, the more times I get to actually play the game.
See if he says something different. You made a donation, did you not? I am farsighted in all things, my brother. What, it is strange, even though they say the bridge has been repaired, my young one in Castletown fails to return. Now we can do it. I'm sure he is hanging his head somewhere around the east gate right at this moment. Here's the plan, my brother. I will prepare some hot spring water, and you will douse the young one to revitalize him. What do you say? Will you do it? I say yes, if you're willing to do that challenge. Otherwise, hand me them sticks, boy!
I'll do it.
But you won't be happy about it. Oh, I see. I am counting on you to make the run, my brother.
I always hated this minigame. I think it took me like 7 to 8 tries before I was actually able to get it right.
Dang. Sorry, I was looking away. Hot spring water cools as time passes, so if you do not hurry, you will end up with plain cold water, my brother. But what about the minerals? Those go away. No, they don't. Yes, they do. I'm an elder. Don't question me.
They leave with the steam.
But I can science.
Okay, where am I going?
Go left. That's where the castle is, right? No, it's not. It's to the right. Unless it is to the left. I can't tell from here.
Oh, okay.
You didn't move the camera. Well, that's dumb. Okay, he's not following you that much now. Can you move the camera at all? We'll let you. If this lever would go away... What is this? It's trying to freaking do... Okay.
Stop
for a second now. Nobody's chasing you. Look for the castle, since we can't see it.
Yeah, I'm heading towards the castle.
How can you be sure?
I'm looking at my mini-map. That guy, the yellow arrows.
Oh, okay. I didn't realize it was on screen, and I forgot that Castletown will be on there. I keep forgetting there's a mini-map. I don't know if you noticed that. I didn't use that while I was playing last time.
Really?
Yeah, I kind of didn't. Oops.
Huh. Well, usually when it comes to...
Don't worry, you can do it. Just... Uh-oh.
Oh.
Time to go back.
Okay, then.
There you go. Fatality. Triple kill.
That's right.
You keep getting that every time, and I haven't gotten it yet so far.
Because I know how to style.
You also know how to do it right at the right time.
God dang it. You want to give the next one a try? Because I do not mind switching off between doing this.
Because we could get the magic armor super early. Of course, we'd still need to earn the money to buy it. But doing this quest will allow the magic armor that has already been put on display for us to actually be able to buy will be severely less. If I read that one guide correctly. And this is really early to get the magic armor, if I remember correctly. I would suggest turning into a wolf at any point, because then you could run faster.
Okay. Because I totally forgot that was an option. Although I'll probably need to, like, turn into a human before actually, like, entering town, huh?
Yeah, probably. I wonder if there's any Poes in town. I highly doubt it. There's probably some in the Goron area.
Yeah. So I know Tsuyoi did this like as much on purpose as he possibly could, but he would wait for Midna to yawn before just jumping and like going into a sprint as Wolf Link to get like that jolt out of her. Yeah. You ever do that?
No, but that is funny.
Yeah, I did that more often than not myself when I think back on it, just because it amused me. You know, also relieved to some of the agitation that she was just there, just yawning, like, on me.
While you're already moving, right?
Well, no.
Oh, never mind.
Like, you know, just standing still.
Man, how do we get up to that church just up there? It's, like, way up there, and I can't remember how. I would only think we need a chicken, but I don't know if there's a chicken up there. You know, I just remembered something that we were from we were talking about during the commercial break, if you will.
Uh-huh.
And I was telling you about, like, oh, like, there's a separate mission where you can solo fight Star Wolf, and I meant to bring something up about that, like, hey, if there was another, like, if they did do the thing of rumors of, like, oh, we're just gonna port Smash Brothers to the NX, and what if Wolf did get in there, and he actually had a different moveset. He learns a new move when you fight him in that level in Star Fox Zero. I forgot exactly what it's called, but I think it was called, like, Spiraling Hurricane. And I want to call it, like, the Ultimate Barrel Roll or something. Because he flies around in a U-turn, and he just spins his jet super fast, and it's got this red aura. And it's he's completely invincible during it, and it does a butt-ton of damage to you. And the only way to
weaponize the barrel roll?
His own version of it. I can't remember the exact name. It's something tornado.
Lightning tornado.
But he can do it in both forms. So even though if you're in the air flying away from them, he can turn into his wolf form and just fly at you. By the way, this is his form before the final battle where he's doing the wolf super early. What confuses me is when you win this battle, he goes, "I can't lose," like he always says, and explodes. And then he comes back in the final battle and is like, "You're dead, I killed you."
Oh, so they keep the mechanized zombie thing.
Well, no, he's already like that in that battle. But since they run away the first time, they seem to just get what looks like either equipment on them to make themselves better or cyber enhancements. Except for Wolf. He just gets angry and puts a bandage on his face. I was like, oh, that's cool. He's too cool to become a cyber wolf.
Oh. Okay, I thought you were going to tell me, except for Wolf, now you see him with the eye patch.
Well, he already has the eye patch.
Yeah,
but
I thought you were going to reveal to me, like, this entire time. Because I've never played Zero, so I don't know if they showed him without it. Boom, now that's how he got the eye patch.
Like, yeah, they gave him the eye patch in 64, but I think the canon of it this time around is he got it fighting Fox's dad, because I forgot that was also a thing before, that it was a thing that came up. It's like, you know, it's just like fighting your father. I was like, oh, is that how you lost the eye? It's like, you take that back. It's like, why? It's the truth. Anywho, if it is you, my brother. You failed, did you not? I am farsighted in all things, my brother. I foresaw your failure. How about you warn me about the levers next time, you jerk? Either way, I just realized my point was, hey, that could be a new Final Smash for Wolf. Do it like Snake's turret reticle, but it's like the Dragoon. It swoops by like three times for your shots. And to do, like, a lot of damage. And that could be his new super move. Like, Wolfen Rush, or whatever the move was called, since I can't remember.
Lightning Tornado!
I was like, that'd be cool. Something like that. Either that or turn, like, pop in the Jaguar mode, or whatever it is. Wolf mode.
I think that'd be better, really. Just get, like, in a giant mecha wolf and run around and just wreck stuff.
And it's better than just having a Wolfen tank. Anywho, farsighted. Alright, I'll prepare more hot spring water for you, and you will douse the young one near Castle Town to revitalize him. What do you say, will you do it? Yes. Oh, I see, I'm counting on you to make the run, brother. Hot spring water cools the time, blah blah blah, I know. I made the logic, and then you unlogic me by being a stubborn old man.
Yeah. You know, I'm expecting you to put up plenty of pictures for during his downtime, but like just nothing is going on the screen because of these long-winded talk sessions.
You mean
ours.
Because of the wolf and stuff?
Yes.
Okay, well,
like, I actually want to see like a good picture of like of the wolf.
Alrighty, well,
especially doing like the red tornado.
That's gonna be a little difficult because he's always flying around.
The red fang over fang.
Yeah, that's a good one for it. You know, I'm surprised this is working. I didn't think it was going to. I was just like, if I stay near the ledge, they won't be able to fly around me in a circle. I just didn't think. Oh no 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 no! Get away! Shoo shoo! No. Stop it.
Okay, well, the fortunate thing about this is that if they hit you, you'll just drop it. I wonder if they made it eat. Why'd you pass that? I think you.
No, that's a wooden bridge. It's a stone bridge that they built over here. Would you go away?
Oh, right, right.
Because what you're talking about in the mini map is like, so he's got to be this way.
Right.
Is the only way across the bridge? Yes. Oh, jeez.
Right, like, I feel like in the original Twilight Princess, if you got hit, you just dropped it and it broke. I don't remember them being forgiving in the sense to where...
Yeah.
And now that I think about it, where's the timer?
I don't know. Say, is that some concrete spring water you have there, brother? Oh, if you poured it on me, I'm sure it would restore my strength. Alrighty. Good, I was hoping that would be already put at the right angle. I don't need to say it now. I feel rejuvenated! That smell, that heat, it is spring water from back home. Oh, well, I'm going to get back to work and open up the shop.
Biesies!
Well, he's really happy about that. And now that it's nighttime and I should try to get the magic armor, except we need money for that, I'm going to go do something else important. Handing the remote to Ado because I forgot for a second. Jeez, this is long! Oh, okay, he's bringing hot spring water for his shop. I didn't remember this. Oh, cool. This is a side quest, so that makes some sense. Oh, we finally got more health. Goody. Got collected 5 for a new heart container. I feel like we at least did this before, but it feels like so long in between parts. Yeah.
I wonder what it was that had them just decide to... It's 5 now instead of 4.
Well, you can ask the same question to... Wait, hold on. No, never mind. I have nothing for that.
Why am I just walking into a void?
Because that just looks like a void for some reason. Why, is it not letting you go on?
Yeah.
Just keep going. It's really long into the loading zone there. They should have at least put a light or something and have the middle of the tunnel dark. I mean, they did that kind of trick all the time in the old games. They'd have like a paper background that turns into the actual object when you get there.
Okay, so Malamart should actually be open or like there, shouldn't it?
Yes, and if I remember correctly, once we made the bridge, they automatically have a Malamart and the magic armor's for sale at an affordable price. But it's made even cheaper when we do this. We don't have money right now because we spent it all donating, but I'm sure it won't be too high of an amount.
Especially
we can actually go back to Agatha while we're here thinking about it.
Where did you think I was going?
Well, I wasn't thinking about that first, okay? I'm a dummy dumb. Sorry. It's just there's no music playing and I'm so used to it.
Yeah.
If I remember correctly, we can buy hot spring water here now, thanks to him bringing it in for the shopping, and get a bottle of that and pour it on the other Goron to open a way to come straight into Castletown from Hyrule Field. You know, from the Ordon Village area. Because there's that rockway, and then I came from the backside, and where Agatha hangs out, there's that Goron there.
Right, but won't we need, like, an empty bottle for that?
Yeah, I don't mind spending our red potion. Or a fairy. I'd rather do the red potion, because we can at least find that anywhere. Like, pretty much. Have you bought a bug for Princess Agatha? What do we got this time that we haven't given?
A butterfly!
I was gonna say we should probably give her a pair first, then we get more money for that, but whatever. Oh boy, who's your little friend? A little girl butterfly, aren't you?
Well, it's all going to her eventually, so...
Yeah, that's a good point. Little butterfly, I want to be wrapped up in that powder, too. And then she became a beautiful butterfly in Hyrule Warriors.
Do butterflies have powder?
I'm thinking of more of the moths is when I know that kind of stuff. That's the only time I've really seen it, but both do actually have a powdery substance on their wing that makes up their pattern, kind of. 14 bugs left, in all.
Because, like, I don't ever remember hearing that kind of stuff in my biology classes.
I remember, like, as a kid, I touched one time when it didn't immediately fly away. Either that or it was a dead one, I forget.
And it just, like, left a powder on your finger or
something? Yeah, no, it was, like, the same color of what was on the wing, pretty much. I was like, that's weird. Oh, boy, who's a little friend? A little boy dragonfly, aren't you, little cutie? Little dragonfly, when you look at me with those great big eyes, I... Oh, no. They're so scary. Oh, boy, thank you so much. I'm so happy. Oh, I just remembered something important, Ado. Speaking of Hyrule Warriors, guess what's coming on the 19th?
A certain little pretty birdie?
Well, that and the rest of the Wind Waker DLC, if you care for that stuff. But yes, the free bird is also there. It's just the same day. Unless it's only for the 3DS, and then we're getting all of it later for the thing. Wait, did you just get done giving her a bug or did I miss a description?
Okay, yeah. I did, but, you know, the same repeating thing, nothing new.
Okay, and the male and female stag beetles.
What else? Oh, I'm on it.
I was about to say, like, what are you doing? Oh, oh boy, who's your friend, a little lady stag beetle, aren't you?
Ah, there we go, that's closer to the look I remember.
That does look a little weird. Because you, if you just pause there for too long.
Yeah,
stop even looking at the bug! Stop it! little stag beetle, your spiky pincers are so sharp, they must feel so good.
Okay.
Why, thank you so much!
And I got...
Purple rupee. Have you brought half of Agatha's guests to the castle? Oh, you have? Okay. Oh, you have brought half of Agatha's guests to my castle! Thank you so much, you made the princess so happy. Here's a bonus. As a symbol of my royal gratitude, please accept this. Here's a bonus! Oh boy, we got the Agatha Meaver stamp. That's really detailed for a stamp. I didn't expect character stamps, but I did see that Zelda one that one time.
Hmm. Well, here's something I never knew I wanted. I am appreciative that I have received the princess's official royal seal of her kingdom.
12 bugs left until I have them all. Gotta catch them all! Get those bugs! Well, only one more to give her right now. Have you brought a bug? I'm a princess. Boo 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 goo. It's like, wait a minute, you sound suspicious like Mallow. And it's like, take off the wig and suddenly it's a shorter person. It's like, how'd you do that disguise? Little male stag beetle, aren't you, little cutie? No,
for some reason, I was just imagining that, like, Mallow was just, like, under the skirt the entire time, and at the top of Agatha was just, like, a puppet or something he was been manipulating.
Well, I was thinking more of the weird cartoon sense of, like, that doesn't logic right. Like, that one episode of Futurama where Leela is a superhero that has the thigh-high boots and the tank top and pants. I mean, no pants. It's just the one leotard. But yes, when she takes it off, then she has suddenly a tank top of pants, which makes no sense. I was just saying, like, he just takes off the wig and then it's just suddenly Mal. It's like, wait, what? Like, how did you do that? Yeah, the spiky pinchers. They're so sharp. It's the same thing for both. But I will read it at least the first time for the new bug. But at this point, I think we have practically one of each, right? Oh, yes, we have a pair. Don't you, those little, don't those little bugs look happy?
Well, a different take on the creep. No, I like this one a little bit more.
Hmm. Let me just share this happiness with you. Is it 1,000 rupees? That's good enough. Yeah, it's golden. Woohoo.
Huh. Why is a golden rupee 100, but a silver rupee 200?
I don't know. Let's start it after Majora's Mask. Wait, hold on. Hold on. Okay, after Majora's Mask, it started being a thing. Because in Majora's Mask, they added the silver rupee, and that became 100. But there was a 200 rupee before in Ocarina of Time. But you could only get that from a Skull Kid, if I remember. I think. No, wait. I remembered just now. There's that secret grotto in Kakariko Village in Ocarina of Time that has two Redeads in it. And you have to bomb that to get it open. And that's where the Shard of Agony or Stone of Agony comes into play. And, yeah, there'd be a, there's a 200 rupee in there, and it's like, you got 200 rupees. And it'd be a gold rupee. And I was like, cool. And it's all golden-y, but it's all orange when it drops in the field. So why'd you do that?
The fairy's bug enough, and I figure, you know, what better place to leave it?
Well, that didn't work out, did it?
I'm going to imagine that it stays here, and it just did, like, a little dance for me as it entered the ballroom. That is now my headcanon. And it shall be the lore of this land that is the castle of this house that has a tree in it. But anyways, we're off to get the fabled spring water.
Should be to the south, because that's where the Gorons were before. Yep, there they are. Father's all better. He can work again. Yay! I'm a baby. I can talk, though. Oh, I remember you, brother. Like, from about, now, it was about 10 minutes ago.
Is it just perspective, or is this guy bigger than most of the other Gorons?
Well, he looked kind of big when we walked up to him, but all Gorons are kind of big in general. But yeah, it might be perspective.
It's just like, I barely come up like to this guy's chest, and I feel like I at least came up to the chests of the other Gorons.
Thanks to you, we are now able to open up shop again. I will give you a special price on hot spring water. How is 20 rupees? That's a steal. Got it, brother. I will provide you with some steaming hot water. Oh, you just pulled that little ladle. I didn't notice that. It's full of nutrients, but drink it while it's hot.
Okay, so should I just run straight down, or like...
No, you want to go to the left on the minimap.
Okay.
When, don't look at the game's fan screen. I saw that. Set it to, and then to replenish all of your hearts, it gets cold, it'll just be ordinary water. And then you just pour it out, and then it's useless. Which I find funny. I was going to say go down the alleyway, but, you know, whatever way to get left, it didn't really matter.
Well, if I went in, down the alleyway, I would go on a curve, and I would think that the shortest distance would be a straight line.
I guess. I mean, I was just thinking in the sense of loading zones. I don't think there's two loading zones for the alleyway. But then again, there probably would be. This looks like it's all one alleyway, according to them. Nice! I've never seen that happen, actually. Crashing into a loading zone.
Okay.
Oh,
so
this is the wrong way. Crap, I thought... Oh, I'm thinking the wrong thing again!
So I was supposed to go south?
No, you're supposed to go right. Unless it was south. Gosh darn it, I'm stupid. I'm sorry, I assume the... No, go back.
Let's at least do a cursory check to make sure that, yes, well, this is the wrong place. So,
there's no dead end here. Wait, was that a bug? Turn back around. That looks like a bug in the distance. Go get it! Get it!
I mean, for sure with this.
Or unless it's a Poe. Either way, it's good. Get it, because we need money. I mean, yeah, we'll get money eventually for collecting Poes. Looks like a bug to me. Watch out, he's gonna get you. Can't dodge too good as a wolf. Like I told you, not too good. Hey, how come Midna's not flashing red? You don't have your sword out yet. Yeah, roll into him. Show him who's boss. Oh, is he just dead? Last time I did that, didn't kill him instantly. Alright, we'll grab it quickly before the hot spring runs out. Oh, didn't we have both butterflies already? A male butterfly. I guess we didn't. Okay, good. Now we have the pair of butterflies. And I found the other butterfly on the other end of Hyrule area. Didn't I? Did I? It was above the cave, right? That's where I found the butterfly?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, then... Yeah, that's way far away from where it was, because the Zora entrance to the south, which is all the loading zone.
Right.
I guess two different sections of Hyrule Field each have one bug, which adds up given where Elden Bridge is and where Ordon's Hyrule Field entrance is. Okay, quickly, to the south, because I am a dummy, and I thought the right side would be the area.
Okay.
But, as I said, I am a dummy.
You really think there's enough time?
I hope so. That'd be way too short. Hasn't been that long since you bought it.
I mean, we just basically got, like, an extra 100 rupees, like, in the pocket.
Yeah, I know, but I'm just saying it shouldn't be out. Actually, it's an extra 150, because she gives you one per bug and then 100 for pairs.
Well, if I remember correctly, she doesn't, like, give you... 54, like, the bug, and then the 100. It's just, like, a straight-up 100 once you bring a pair.
I guess so.
Okay, so...
Just keep going. He's at the very south. Unless he's not there because it's night, but that'd be dumb. He's supposed to be there because he's stuck. And don't worry about the jingling. We already found that bug. Wait, aren't you going to not be able to change if you're near him? Okay.
No, because, like, he's back is to me.
Yeah, well, sometimes the game won't care for that detail. Okay, talk to him and see. I thought you said, if I dank enough... hot spring water. Okay, I guess try pouring it at him. Yeah, just put it at him. That didn't do anything. Okay. I thought we
could... Yeah, it probably ran out, and it just
didn't get
the message.
Otherwise you would have drank it. Okay, so that was a really short time. This game is dumb, I hate it.
Alright, so then grab some water, run down here, and then give it to him.
Yeah. I'm really glad that we're doing the fetch quest now of all random things instead of continuing with the story, because I was wanting to focus on this a little bit more in between story bits, but there's like, there's too much stuff that we have to do before we're allowed to do anything. And now that we're doing it, it's like, I feel like we're doing a little too much, but I don't care.
Yeah, you know, it just gives me time to focus on things I like.
Yeah, we could actually talk about stuff more instead of being interrupted every 2 seconds. Unlike in Shovel Knight, where I think we talked about Goosebumps for like 3 episodes, basically. Yeah. And since that only came out like, well, I think it was once a week because of how our schedule's going right now. Roll faster! Whee! Okay, now it should be good if you talk to him. Oh, you again? You have some sweet smell of hot spring water. If I took a drink of that, I would feel so strong, invincible. Okay, maybe not that far. I could probably get rid of these rocks, though. Does that sound good? Well, if you want to get through here, could you give me a swig of that hot spring water you have there, please, pretty please? Here you go. Oh boy. Oh, that's good. Yeah! Go on, power, go! Well, I'm going to get working on this, so come back in a little while. One day later, after just grind drilling into the wall with his body, I wonder if you can talk to him still. Nope. It'd be fun if you can get hurt from that. The rocks spraying everywhere should hurt you enough, though. Look at this violent destruction.
I feel like if I did the right thing, I'd probably be able to glitch myself on the other side of that wall.
Well, if you Z target now, not like that, aim like diagonally away from him. Yeah. If it doesn't send you to the left, then you could jump right and... Okay, just send you that way. I don't doubt somebody would have already tried that for speedrunning tricks or something, although this is just a direct path to some place that you don't need really too much importance of.
Okay. Well, that took care of that. And, wrong button.
It's okay. Also, I was right in the number of poses we have left to get, I think, unless I'm reading that list wrong. Also, just realized, with his getting 20 poses, we actually only needed to get 19, and we have 11, so we need 8 more. You think there'd be poses out here somewhere? It's that bug we already have, unless you really need a heart. Which, you know,
heart?
If you had noticed, whenever we catch a bug we already have, they drop one heart. I don't think they do it multiple times, but... I don't think I ever noticed that teleport was in the sky over there from every angle. I guess this, all of his stuff is roughly in the similar same loading zone. Or else it's detail. Like how there's the owl statue that you can see out of the loading zone area Majora's Mask. Which isn't there in the Japanese version, that was added in the North American version. And, what are you doing?
I thought I heard jingling.
That's you! You have a chain on your friggin' ankle. It's very annoying, actually. Because that's what I kept mishearing too, as a wolf. At least you can improve yourself to stuff with senses like this. I think one of the weirdest, neatest secrets in Ocarina of Time is just like random places that have invisible hidden money that you can get to. Which, now that I think about it, I'm not sure there actually is more than the one at the Hyrule Bridge. Like, if you go climb up the chain and wait till night or turn at night, the drawbridge goes all the way up. And if you walk across the top of it, there's like 320 rupees up there. So you can get like a quick 60 rupees that way. You listening? I'm only... Oh, yeah. This guy. This guy! So like the magic herb is only like 1,000 rupees after reducing it, right?
I am not sure.
Anywho. Agatha. Hey, my girl, I brought you another bug already, because it was just outside the door, or something like 3 feet away.
Let's see, how would he put it? A bug from my bugaboo?
Now, I wonder who he is. A friend, little boy butterfly, aren't you? Little cutie. Wow, little butterfly, all wrapped up with that power, I want to be. By the way, I don't think I've ever said this at all before or anything, but... Oh, we have a pair again. Yeah, that's right. I don't think I've said this before in any LP or anything, but anytime that I'm just doing voices for characters, that's usually what I'm trying to do of what I am imagining in my head of what they would have sounded like. On first appearance! Not what I'm doing right now, though. Like, I can only do so much as, voice work, because I don't have a wide range, sadly.
For some reason, your voice just reminded me of, that voice of...
Yes?
There's this guy who does animations. I'm trying to remember his name. Rice Pirates? Maybe. Like, he did this one League of Legends like animation that I really liked. Which was basically like this big old bull with like some really high-def nipples. Just to see the life out of like a little girl, but like it had like a really gruff man's voice. It goes like la la la. It still sounded that way throughout the entire beating that she was getting. It was hilarious.
I am terribly sorry, but it's nighttime. We're closed. Get out of here. Go away forever. Bye.
Okay.
It's too bad that Wii U Zelda screenshots disappear from that shop when Mala takes over.
Ah, that's a thing?
Yes, and that's why I wanted to make sure we saw it before, because I learned about that.
Well, it's a good thing we basically did like a look over that entire place.
Yeah, I'm just glad I looked at one episode of Game Explained. If everybody hasn't seen that, then they can see that who's watching our series.
So, should we donate more money to this guy?
I say we wait until we get the magic armor. Is it turning daytime?
Yes, it is.
No, we need money. We're going to get more money. Lots of money fast.
Well, actually, I was like going to ask, like, where do we go next? Because I do have an idea of where we should go next. But after that, I'm kind of... Oh, no, wait. There is another place which I can think where we can go next.
I would suggest trying it out, but keep an eye out for Pose. But it's daytime, so never mind. I swear, next episode, I'm going to grind for those and use the guide for real this time. I was about to say, what's going on? I want to warp. It's like, well, geez, fine.
Like I said, the more I have a chance to play this, the more I'm learning how to play.
But, is there any wolf learning to do?
Ah, right. Well, I know we haven't learned all the sword skills, but I can't think of any place that
I don't think we've unlocked any others. Otherwise, it would show on the map, right?
Right, we would.
I just couldn't find the one that was hiding at Ordon that we had skimmed over completely.
Let's see, we're here. Huh? And
why the hell am I whispering that? I don't care. I guess I just want to interrupt you if you're talking at all, really. Oh, that's right, this dungeon. Well, we have enough bombs because we have a whole sack of other regular bombs.
Oh, I totally forgot about that dungeon.
Then I'll do it next time. Don't leave here. But yeah, I forgot about the fairy. Hey, at least we do know of a good place for it. That's pretty awesome. Mm-hmm. Are you close enough? Okay, but say, like, we aren't close enough.
You captured a brand new friend. Just give enough time for Stockholm Syndrome to set in, and she'll sacrifice her life for you right before you die.
Who says that's them dying? They just go back to the fairy realm.
I said
that's
right before you die.
Uh-oh. Well, you said sacrifice themselves right before you die. I'm like, hey, who says they die in the process of that?
I guess sacrifice themselves would basically imply that I'm saying
but,
that they
Yeah, but to say, like, I can't think of a time where sacrificing oneself doesn't usually imply the ending of a life, which is never good, unless, of course, it's saving all the peoples.
I always looked at sacrifice in terms of, like, take a loss of some sort.
Yeah. It really depends on how specific you're being. In that case, it really sounded like everything.
And I'm back to full health without even needing that fairy.
Also, wow, I didn't realize how much bloom appears here for when it's morning time. It's really pretty, actually. It's like the morning haze.
Mm-hmm.
Which isn't a bad thing.
So, do we have enough time for me to go through that dungeon?
Given how long we don't know that it is, I would say no, and go do something, I guess. I don't know. It's either way, get into now.
Well, because my only other plan was, like, I totally forgot about that dungeon, but I remembered another dungeon that we pretty much passed up because we didn't have bombs at the time.
Would that be back in Ordon? I'm trying to think here.
Nah, it's, let's see, hang on.
Bring it up on the big map so I can see better. I can't see the gamepad.
Okay, let's
see. Be the zoom out. There you go.
I'll
try to make a note of it after attacking this dungeon because we are getting... I don't want to go too far over again.
That way, no, it was like, as we made our way this way, we pretty much, it's along one of these paths, to where, like, it's a door that you just basically got to blow up and you go through, like, a puzzle. I think it's up here. Yeah, some up here, like, along, like, this pathway.
There is some kind of secret entrances around the area that's before the bridge leading to Kakariko, but I can see on the map there's a weird little tunnel grayed out, too. That means we haven't gone there yet. At the very bottom left, before the darkened out area. See that one? To the left? Right there.
Huh.
Yeah, that seems like it could be an extra tunnel somewhere, but more so than that, I think there is a secret dungeon-y area around there. But I guess we'll have to do that next time, won't we?
Very well. in the next episode. Bye. Later, everyone.
Bye.